The United Nations is urging Australia to protect its Great Barrier Reef, the world's biggest collection of coral. Located on Australia's northeastern coast, it's home to about 1,500 species of fish. Now, man-made coastal developments could damage the reef, already grappling with climate change. The World Heritage Committee is threatening to list the reef as a threatened ecosystem. Now, that move could have a big impact on the region's multi-billion dollar tourism industry. Well, joining us now from Canberra is Tony Burke. He is Australia's Minister for the Environment. Minister, thanks very much for joining us here on CNN. The World Heritage Committee report, which was issued in Cambodia earlier this week, was quite critical of the Australian government's efforts to protect the reef. It says that the government basically not really doing enough. First, what is your response to that?
Well, I don't necessarily agree with the thesis you've got of what they've concluded. In other parts of the report, they've referred specifically to the high quality of management of the Great Barrier Reef Marine Park Authority, which is a government authority. The important thing here is there are two sorts of threats to the Great Barrier Reef. That's right. That's right. They do talk about that, and some of the timelines in terms of reports that they wanted finished by particular dates are still being conducted, and that's part of making sure that the right scientific rigour is behind them. But there are two sorts of threats to the Great Barrier Reef. There are the threats because of the impacts of climate change, which is your more intense weather events, your coral bleaching issues, and also your issues there, which are not specifically climate change, but caused by the same thing, which is ocean acidification. Now, all of those issues are having a very direct impact on the health of the reef. Added to that, the biggest issue, far and away, even though the biggest campaign has been about port development, the biggest issue is about runoff from land. So when you get those major weather events, the agricultural pollutants, the aspects of sediment that make their way from land into the ocean become far and away the biggest of the threats that government, as a national government, can have a direct impact on doing something about.
OK. Minister, I would like to ask you, you did mention that that point about port development, because the Heritage Committee actually have identified this as a major concern for them. They say their worry is that the Australian government will now allow new sites for coal handling facilities rather than expanding existing sites within the Barrier Reef Zone. New greenfield sites, which they say threatens the health of the reef. What do you say to that? I mean, is the Australian government prepared to open up entire new areas for port development, new facilities on that coastal zone?
We have a strategic assessment, which is a legal process we have that then effectively establishes the rules up and down the Queensland coast. Now, that's being conducted at the moment. The important thing to note, though, is in terms of any approvals that have been coming from the federal government, or indeed from the state government for that matter, there have not been approvals coming through in any of the pristine locations. Similarly, one of the pristine locations which the World Heritage Committee had taken a particular interest in, a place called Balaclava Island. The proponent there, Xstrata, since the last year's meeting and this year's meeting of the World Heritage Committee, have withdrawn their application. So while the World Heritage Committee continues to say they don't want any developments to go in the pristine locations, it remains the case that there have been none approved. There are a number of companies with applications, and there are legal processes that those applications trigger. But there are no examples, I repeat, no examples of those pristine locations being turned into dredge locations and ports.
OK, you have been described as being held to ransom by radical Greens. That description coming from the state deputy leader at the state of Queensland, where the reef is located, of course. Is a tension between federal and state governments likely to have a negative impact on the Australian government being able to convince the World Heritage Organisation that it's doing the right thing, that it will get there in time, meet that deadline?
Yeah, look, it was pretty colourful language that the Deputy Premier used against me. I think I was basically being pinned as being a hostage in some way. Look, the truth is all of the criticisms that the Queensland government have levelled at me are because, and Queensland's one of the states of Australia, their criticisms levelled at me are quite simply because they think I've been too protective of the Great Barrier Reef. Well, that's a label I'm happy to wear, and I think it's a label that would only give confidence to the World Heritage Committee and to UNESCO.
It'd be an enormous embarrassment, though, if they did put this in danger listing on the Barrier Reef, wouldn't it?
Well, each year for the last couple of years, there have been campaigns predicting that it was about to happen. The World Heritage Committee have looked at it, looked at the evidence, and determined that at this point in time it shouldn't be put on the in danger list. Let's not pretend that the only issues that could contribute to the in danger listing are issues within the control of national governments. They're not. You know, some of them go to international action like climate change. One of the massive impacts, for example, which is connected to agricultural runoff, are the crown of thorns starfish. Now, they occur naturally within the Great Barrier Reef. But when you get a lot of sediment and runoff, they breed into numbers that are themselves unnatural and start physically eating the coral. Now, we've been sending divers down with injections, you need three injections to kill every one of these starfish, and they've got rid of in the order of 75,000. So all of these individual actions are occurring.